YouTube recently announced that it's bringing its premium subscription music service to the UK and other territories. Hey, this is Chia from Brand24. Welcome to the Social Recap, a rundown of all the latest highlights and trends from social media and digital marketing news. So first up, Google has taught its medical brain AI how to predict a patient's risk of mortality, discharge, and readmission even more accurately than many hospitals. So by taking a wider range of patient data into consideration and then teaching its AI how to read that data, Google's predictive algorithm has shown higher accuracy than traditional hospital systems in terms of predicting patient health and medical needs. So in fact, in one of its earlier studies, a hospital predicted a 9.3% risk of mortality for a patient with breast cancer, while Google's medical brain predicted a higher 19.9% risk. The patient sadly passed away less than 2 weeks later, but as we can see, the higher rate that Google predicted was more accurate than the prediction from the hospital itself. So a big part of why medical brain has higher accuracy is because Google's AI reads all the notes that doctors make about each patient in their emergency health records, while many hospital warning systems base their predictions on a smaller subset of data. So Google is currently exploring ways it can improve the accuracy of medical brain even more. This includes voice recognition so that doctors won't have to manually make notes for patient files. And while this would streamline the medical process a great deal, it would require tremendous accuracy on the part of Google to avoid any major disasters. If they're able to do all this while complying with data security regulations, medical brain would be making huge advancements in medical care, minimizing the risk of human error. So next, Twitter is making Instream Video Ads available to all advertisers in 12 different global markets. The decision to expand Instream Video Ads was supported by data showing how well the strategy has been working for brands. Research from Nielsen reported that Instream Video Ads help improve ad awareness by 70%, brand awareness by 28%, and even viewer purchase intent by 6%. And the benefits aren't just restricted to brands. Video publishers on Twitter saw a 60% increase in year-over-year revenue within 2017, and half of Twitter's own $575 million revenue from quarter one of last year came solely from video ads, which isn't really all that surprising considering that video views in general have doubled on Twitter in just 1 year. So meanwhile, Instagram wants its users to shop inside Instagram stories and not just in feed posts. Shoppable Instagram stories are currently being tested by a few select brands like Adidas and Louis Vuitton. They put shopping bag stickers by their products inside their Instagram stories, and then users can just tap on the stickers to see more details about the items. So this move will help Instagram go from a platform that offers inspiration to one that's more action-based, where users can go to purchase items directly or find more information about products that they're interested in. So you would think that shoppable Instagram stories would mean that the platform wants people to spend as much time as possible inside their app, but that doesn't seem to be the case. So Instagram doesn't want its users to waste away too much time online, so they're looking into daily reminders as part of their new usage insights feature. Daily reminders will let users track and limit the amount of time that they spend on the platform, and maybe even decrease mindless scrolling through the feed that prevents users from truly seeing what's inside each post. And Pinterest continues to scale up, or help their users with that, by introducing a creative specialty to their marketing partners program. The marketing partners program itself is designed to help brands create really great pins, which they can then use to measure and grow their presence on Pinterest. So the new creative specialty provides access to tools that marketing partners have built through the Pinterest API, including QuickFrame, Shutterstock Custom, VidMob, and Vidsy. There are over 10,000 designers, photographers, editing tools, and more that brands can access in the creative specialty, which will help businesses create content for Pinterest on a greater scale. And we've seen that Facebook has been updating its policies pretty regularly after the data security leak. Well, one of its most recent updates includes a new age restriction on weapons-related ad targeting. So ads for the sale and use of weapons, ammunition, and explosives are not actually permitted on Facebook. But previously, there weren't really any restrictions for promoting weapons-related interest groups, gun safety courses, and certain types of weapons accessories. That is until this recent announcement, which limits weapons-related ad targeting to users who are 18 and older. And on a more musical note, YouTube recently announced that it's bringing its premium subscription music service to the UK and other territories, officially throwing their hat in the ring with similar providers like Spotify and Apple Music. So Google plans to stand out by offering more advanced search capabilities, one that's able to understand typos, incorrectly remembered names, and mispronounced titles to still pull up the right song that users are really looking for. Plus, YouTube movie subscribers will also be able to enjoy uninterrupted background play, a new feature that lets YouTube continue playing music even when users have another app open. And a fresh UX for both the mobile app and the desktop version has been designed to help listeners discover more of the music they enjoy based on location, their listening patterns, as well as recent activity. Well, that's it for this episode of The Social Recap. Don't miss out on the latest trends and highlights in social media and digital marketing news. Subscribe to The Social Recap on YouTube for more inspiration, insights, and, of course, news. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Bye.